Hey, I am Yale, and just like you, I am stuck at home. Nothing really changed for me. I'm just pressing buttons in my room like I always do. My brain was still recovering from the crazy maths of my last game, Fractal Collector, so I was in need of something simple. But then I got this cool Arduino set, so simple went right out of the window. If I was going to be stuck inside for a month, I might as well make a cool game with my new toys. Before I got to work, I took a small toilet break. Moments later, my heart skipped a beat. I used the last piece of toilet paper. I watched the news and everyone reported that there was no more toilet paper. Everyone was hoarding every piece of paper like there was no tomorrow. I had to do something before I had to go to the toilet again. Because then I would have a real problem. If only I had the power to make something that could keep them busy, so I could go to the store and get my stuff. Oh yes, I was going to make a game to distract the toilet paper hoarders. In order to make my plan work, I had to make the experience as believable as possible. Luckily, I had an Arduino set ready to be used. I wanted to recreate the feeling of actually holding a shopping cart without the need for pressing any buttons, because that would take them out of the simulation. You've probably all played Mario Kart before, so you know how smooth and easy it is to race with motion controls. Connecting the Arduino to Unity was pretty straightforward. You can get all the source files on GitHub in the link in the description, by the way. Unity has a built-in serial port manager to read and send data through a USB port. The Arduino side works very similar, just use serial.write to send the data back to the computer. The first tests went very smooth. I connected some buttons to the Arduino which would send a different number back to the computer. That number would be converted to a direction for the cube to move in. Of course, I didn't want to use simple buttons, I wanted to use motion controls. And for that, I could use an accelerometer. An accelerometer measures proper acceleration, meaning that when we are on Earth and hold the accelerometer still, it will give you a vector pointing straight up, because there is normal force being applied to it, keeping it in place, to counter the gravity of the Earth. I used that direction to determine the rotation of the accelerometer. That direction could then be translated into a forwards and backwards motion and a rotation amount. It works like magic. However, there was still one problem, that stupid cable. Luckily, there are Bluetooth adapters. Just connect your Arduino like a pair of wireless headphones and it works as if it's connected with a cable. This way, I could send the necessary data wirelessly. I also needed an external power source to power the whole thing. Using a simple power bank worked wonders. Now that all the components work great together, it was time to make it look like a real shopping cart handle. Let's go! Look at this authentic, wonderful shopping cart handle. If you gave this to a toilet paper hoarder, I'm sure they wouldn't see the difference. For the simulation to feel real, the actual game had to be believable as well. I created a pack of toilet paper that would be indistinguishable from the real deal. And I even made a toilet roll with a simulated loose flap. The lengths that I went through, unbelievable. The store itself needed to look as empty as possible to make sure the player would focus on the toilet paper right from the get-go. The boring grayness really helped here. Normally, toilet paper would be restocked every now and then, but that's no fun. Here, you have to fight for it and catch it in your cart. The toilet paper comes out of these big tubes that move around, so you will need to chase them if you want that sweet soft paper. To make it even more difficult, I added some trash heaps from destroyed carts, so you would have to maneuver your way around them. Of course, you're never the only one who is looking for toilet paper. I added some other carts that would race you to the toilet paper spawners. They are very fast and smart. It's like they know exactly where the toilet paper is going to be. You'll have to be fast, or else they will take the toilet paper for themselves, and you will be left empty-handed. But there was still one thing missing. I needed the ability to scream other customers away. Using an audio source and a microphone input, I could make the game do something when the dB value got above a certain threshold. In other words, things go boom when you scream loud. I created three game modes, all based on the same principle of collecting toilet paper in your cart and bringing it back to checkout. The modes are Time Attack, Max Points, and Golden Drop.
Time Attack
is a mode where you have to bring back as much toilet paper as possible in a given time limit.
You lose. In Max Score,
you must be the first one to collect a certain amount of toilet paper.
You lose.
And in
Golden Drop,
there is only one toilet paper roll left, and you need to get it to checkout. But be careful, the other customers are on the hunt as well.
You win.
When I play the game, I really feel like a toilet hoarder, screaming and racing for every possible chance to get some paper. So, go play the game right now on itch.io, and don't worry, you can also play it with your mouse and keyboard. And be sure to play it long enough so I can finally go out and get my paper. Stay inside, people. As usual, I've put all the source files on GitHub as a link in the description below, so you can easily make your own game with Arduinos and voice control. Be sure to like the video if you enjoyed this little adventure, and subscribe if you want to see more in the future. And I see you guys next time, where I'll unfold the space-time continuum to reinvent the wheel. Bye!